Well, good afternoon, students. Today we are going to see some more photographs. Already we have gone through photographs in the last practical. Some more photographs from exam point of view. Okay, the photograph which we are going to study is of postmortem. Now, what is this postmortem lividity? It is nothing but bluish or purplish discoloration of the skin, mainly caused by stoppage of circulation and stagnation of blood in the vessels. Now see, here is a tabular form of name of the poison and color imparted to the lividity by it. Carbon monoxide, it gives cherry red color. HCN gives bright red color. Nitrites gives red brown color. Phosphorus gives dark brown color, while hydrogen sulfide gives bluish green. What is the medical legal importance? See, this lividity, it is going to develop only after the death of a person. So it is a sign of death. First thing, it is a sign of death. It helps in estimating the time of death. How does it help in estimating the time of death? It develops because it develops 1 to 1.5 hours after the death of a person. See, it begins developing in the form of small patches after 1 to 1.5 hours of death. It in the form of small patches between 2 to 4 hours, it goes on increasing in size. So again, it gives you time since death. After 4 hours, these patches, they combine together, they coalesce with each other and give rise to one big patch. So again, you are able to estimate the time since death. This is how it helps in estimating the time since death. Now, the other importance is it indicates the posture at the time of death because it develops in the dependent parts of the body. It also indicates moving of body to another person. How? Now, this lividity, whenever there is change in the position of the body, it gives rise to new patches until it is fixed. By about 8 hours after the death of a person, it gets fixed up. And that is why, again, before that, if you change the position of the body, new patches are developed. That is why it indicates moving of the body to another person. And as we have already seen, the color indicates the cause of death. Now we will come to the next photograph, which is of foot. Now, what is this footprint? It is the impression left by the sole of the foot. Skin pattern of the toes and heels are distinctive and they help for identification. Now, what is the peculiarity of this particular impression left by the sole of the foot? See, as the feet grows, the lines too grow with them without any change in their pattern. See, what is the factor? Without any change in their pattern. So what is the medical legal importance? This footprint, if taken shortly after birth, in bigger institutions, as there is possibility of exchange of infants, this footprint, if it is taken shortly after birth, it will help you in identifying the particular infant. Now in Air Force, it is a rule to have a record of footprint since feet resist destruction by air accidents and fires. Now, the congenital abnormalities of the foot, for example, flat foot, web foot, supernumerary toes, if present, they help for identification because it is not going to be present in each and every individual. Now coming to the next photograph, which is of the stab. What are the features of this stab wound or what is the definition? It is an injury caused by pointed weapon. Which are the pointed weapons which can give rise to stab wound? Examples are knife, dagger, needle, a spear, a arrow, ice pick or scissors. Now what are the different types of stab wound? It can be penetrating wound, it can be perforating wound. What is penetrating wound? It is caused when the above mentioned weapons enter the body cavities like thorax or abdominal cavity. Which is the other type of stab wound? Perforating wound. What is this perforating wound? After penetrating the tissues, when the weapon comes out from the other side, giving rise to exit wound, it is known as perforating wound. Now, when we are saying exit wound, definitely it has to give rise to wound of entry. So, more or less, what is a stab wound? Whenever there is an wound of entry and wound of exit, it is known as stab wound. And always keep in mind, wound of entry is bigger in size compared to the wound of entry. Now, we are going to study the next photograph, which is of grazed abrasion. Now, what is this grazed abrasion? It occurs when the movement takes place between the skin and some rough surface in contact with it. What are the characteristics of this grazed abrasion? It gives rise to uneven longitudinal parallel lines with heaped up epithelium at the end of the lines, which indicates the direction of force applied. The heaped up epithelium of the parallel lines, it is going to indicate the end point. What it is going to indicate? It is going to indicate the end point. So what will be the other point is going to be the starting point. Now, grazed abrasions, they are commonly seen in road accidents. Why road accidents? Because, see, when we have defined it, it is nothing but it is movement which takes place between the skin and rough surface. This commonly happens when the body is dragged by the tire of the vehicles. It may be a bicycle, it may be the tire of a two-wheeler, it may be the tire of a four-wheeler, whatever it is. At that time, the body, when it is dragged along the rough surface of the road, it gives rise to this type of abrasions. Now, what are the different types of grazed abrasion? It is one of them is brush burn or gravel rash. Now, this is nothing but it is abrasion caused by violent lateral rubbing against a surface, that is by dragging on the ground. One more type of grazed abrasion is friction burn, which is extensive superficial reddened excoriated area without serious ooze or bleeding with little or no linear mark. Now we are going to study the next photograph, which is nothing but froth seen in case of drowning. Froth is seen in case of drowning. See what happens in case of drowning. Whenever the water enters in large amounts through the nasal cavities, while entering or while passing through the trachea on the inner side, it is lined by the mucous membrane, which secretes mucus. Now, when the water along with the dirt is entering inside, it irritates the mucous membrane, due to which large amount of mucus is going to be secreted and which is going to come out in the form of a froth or foam. So what is it? Fine, white, leathery froth or foam is seen at the mouth and nostrils, which is one of the characteristic signs, external signs of drowning. Now, when fine froth is the characteristic external sign of drowning, we have also studied hanging. What is the characteristic external sign of hanging? It is salivation. It is the salivation. That is the difference between the two. Now, what happens? Violent respiratory efforts convert mixture of endogenous secretions and drowning medium into froth. This froth, it contains protein, water, fine bubbles which do not readily collapse, and when touched due to the presence of surfactant. Froth, it projects in the form of a small balloon or mushroom-like mass from the mouth and nostrils. Froth, It is common in seawater drowning. What are the different types of drowning? Seawater drowning and freshwater drowning. This froth is common in seawater drowning. It is blood stained due to intrapulmonary bleeding and it reappears when pressure is applied on the chest. The next photograph is of left black eye. Positive factors of this black eye. It is mainly caused when direct blow or click in front of the orbit gives rise to bruising lids. See, scalp is very rich in blood supply. Forehead is very rich in blood supply. Whatever blood comes out through the arteries or oozes through the arteries, it should have some space to accumulate. And the nearest place for this blood to accumulate is the lax tissue which is present below the lower eyelid or around the lids and which gives rise to black discoloration. Now, injury to forehead gives rise to tracking of blood under the scalp which comes down, gets collected around the orbit. In the same way, whenever there is fracture of the base of the skull, in anterior fossa, blood comes out, gets collected in the orbital plates and gives rise to eye. Coming to the next photograph, which is of skeletal region. Now, as far as skeletal remains are concerned, what are the characteristic features when they are seen, when it develops? Now, it is time required for skeletonization depends upon ambient temperature, insect colonization of the body and scavenger activity. Hot, humid environment with heavy insect activity, skeletonization of body takes place within few days. While in case of exposed bodies, flies, maggots, ants, rats, dogs, vultures reduce the body to skeleton within a few days. In case of water, fresh and crabs reduce the body to skeleton within few days. In uncoffined body or deeply buried body, putrefaction and decomposition are delayed. So skeletonization, it will take place at a later period. While in India, uncoffined buried body is reduced to skeleton within 1 year. Now, disc articulation of this skeleton, it occurs from head downwards and from the central part to the peripheral parts. All these buried bones, they decay at different periods. Neutral soil may not destroy the skeleton at all. Next photograph which we are going to study is of tattoo marks. What are these tattoo marks? They are small multiple punctured wounds made on the skin with the help of needles or some penetrating tools which are dipped in the dyes. Which are the dyes commonly used? The color of the dyes is mainly black, blue and red. Black, commonly the soot, it is used for black color, while the vermilion, it is used for red color. Now, the permanency of these tattoo marks, it depends upon the depth which the penetrating tool reaches. If it reaches only the epidermal layer, it remains for a shorter time. Why? Because the epidermal layer is daily lost due to daily wear and tear of the body. If it enters the dermal layer, the permanency is more. Why? Because the lymph nodes which are present in the dermal layer carry the pigments to the nearest group of lymph nodes. Along with that, destruction of dermal layer takes place only after the epidermal layer, which is at a later period. In unidentified and putrefied bodies, if the tattoo marks can be photographed with sharp definition, if loose, epidermis is first removed and the design on the dermis is marks. These tattoo marks, they can be eliminated, or a second one can be superimposed to conceal the identity. Artificial means for elimination of tattoo marks are derm abrasion, application of caustic substances, electrolysis, plastic surgery, exposure to laser beams. What is the medico-legal importance? It helps in identification. How does it help in identification? Now, what happens whenever personal events of life of a particular person are tattooed on the part of a body, with the help of the history taken by the relatives, you can get the clue as to the identity of the person. The design on the body can also indicate the race of a person, profession of a person, and occupation of the person. Particular criminal gangs have specific designs of tattoo marks on the body. It also indicates the behavioral characteristics, that is blue blood design of homosexuals. The next photograph which we are going to study is of adipocare or saponification. Saponification or adipocare formation is nothing but soap-like substance formed in the body. Which is that particular part of the body which undergoes soap-like change? Those are the fatty tissues. What happens after the death of a person? The pre-existing fats undergo hydrolysis and hydrogenation under the influence of lipase. In normal individuals, it becomes visible 1/2 to 1 hour after the death. Initially, 1 to 2 centimeter diameter patches begin appearing within 30 minutes to 2 hours. These patches deepen, increase in intensity, coalesce with each other within 4 hours. Within 6 to 12 hours, they reach their maximum intensity, and these patches develop mainly in the dependent parts of the body. Now, where are these patches commonly seen? They are seen at the sites where fatty tissue is present. Which are these sites? They are mainly the face, that is the cheek, the buttocks, the breast, the abdomen. What is the medico-legal importance? Again, why we are studying this? When face is involved, it helps in identifying the body because the features are maintained. While injuries on the body are preserved, hence it gives the cause of death, it also gives time since death. What are the factors which favor the development of this adipocare formation? Warm, moist, anaerobic environment. It is mainly seen in females. It is seen in case of well-nourished, mature, newborn children, in obese persons, and also in bodies submerged in water for a long period. While in fetus under 7 months, they do not show this particular